Before we visit the beautiful city of Porto, don't forget to subscribe to World Travel Guide and ring the bell to get notified about the latest videos. Porto is the second largest city in Portugal and one of the Iberian Peninsula's major urban areas. Located along the Douro River estuary in northern Portugal, Porto is one of the oldest European centers, and its core was proclaimed a World Heritage Site by UNESCO in 1996, as historic Center of Porto, Luiz Bridge and Monastery of Serra do Pilar. The historic area is also a National Monument of Portugal. The western part of its urban area extends to the coastline of the Atlantic Ocean. Its settlement dates back many centuries, when it was an outpost of the Roman Empire. Porto City is small compared to its metropolitan area, with a population of 237,000 people. Porto's metropolitan area has an estimated 1.7 million people in an area of 2,400 square kilometers, making it the second largest urban area in Portugal. Porto is one of the oldest cities of Portugal and it is the city after which the country is named. It has played an important role in not just Portuguese, but Iberian history. Portugal's second largest city is full of history and variety, from the worn of labyrinthine streets that make up the ancient Ribeira district, to the Grand Plaza of the Trindade district. The wider region is famed for the production of port, a sweet red fortified wine, which is stored and matured to this day in the vast, ancient cellars that stretch along the banks of the Douro River. Porto's bridges are the city's most recognizable sites, and have been not only vital to the city's survival and prosperity, but also to its character and beauty. Dom Luiz Bridge is an icon of the city. It covers the River Douro and connects the port winehouses of Gaia with downtown Ribeira. It was built in honor of King Luiz I, the reigning monarch of the time. Porto's river, the Douro, runs between Porto and Gaia. It has been a place of triumph and tragedy. It helped the city withstand a siege, but it was also the scene of a tragedy in which thousands of people lost their lives. Its banks remain places worth seeing as they are beautiful and filled to the brim with history. Porto's Ribeira district extends from the riverbank into the city, and is the historical center, the Old Town. It is filled with monuments for you to visit. The São Francisco Church is well worth a visit, as it is classified as a national monument. While visiting this church, it will be hard to miss the Palácio da Bolsa, one of the most important historic monuments in Porto. It was built in the second half of the 19th century, in the neoclassical style, and served as a center of commerce and culture. It has a rich history and looks majestic, inside and out. Porto lies within the beautiful Costa Verde coastline and is surrounded by numerous outstanding beaches. This stretch of coastline faces the mighty Atlantic Ocean and is formed of vast expanses of golden sands, rocky headlands, and dramatic natural scenery. On Porto's seaside is the Foz do Douro area, beginning at the mouth of the Douro River and extending north, featuring beach after beach and lots of sights. Many of the beaches are easily accessible from central Porto and are connected by the city's inexpensive public transport network. The best time to visit Porto is from May to September, when the weather is often sunny and warm. Overall, Porto experiences a moderate climate. Summertime temperatures are high but bearable, and the breezes and nearby beaches will help you stay cool. The fall brings lower temperatures and occasional drizzle, while in the winter you'll certainly encounter some rain. Springtime also sees showers and moderate temperatures,